I used to live nearby the Amsterdam Zoo. Anyone who lives near artists knows the concerts the gibbons give on Sunday morning while everyone in the city is still sleeping. Or is trying to sleep, because the solos with dazzling glissandi are very high and extremely loud. They are a kind of opera singers. These concerts are beautiful, but at the same time, I think human opera singing is rather weird. It is also very loud, but it seems a bit forced, unnatural. That made me wonder, is singing a natural thing? What is singing? Is singing a cultural development of humanity, high art? Or is it a very basic thing, something we always go back to, deeply nested in our limbic system? We all know that babies, stutterers, and demented elderly love to sing. To find the answers to these questions, I started doing research on the vocalization of our closest relatives, apes. I wanted to find out if monkeys are able to sing. So I took my tape recorder and I went to the zoo. Also, I looked for sound clips on the internet in the libraries of sound producing or singing monkeys. I made transcriptions of 10 beautiful ape recordings, and I discovered when such a vocal snippet of a transcribed singing monkey, recorded monkey, is repeated really slowly, it sounds like early medieval music. Let me give you an example of the singing of a chimpanzee. Okay, I'm a composer, I'm not a singer. I therefore asked four of my friends to join me, the famous Egidius Quartet, specialized in Renaissance singing, and they are going to sing the same fragment. Monkeys do sing. I found out that there are conceptual similarities between, for instance, pygmy singing, early medieval singing, and the singing of monkeys. they all use short rhythmic cycles, repetition of melodic themes, yodeling, panthood, woo-hoo, and often in a free feeling like a waltz. Ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. Let me give you another example sung by a gibbon. Gibbons sing for fun in family duos or trios, duets, trios, from one tree to the other, joie de vivre. Whoop, whip, 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 whip. These are beautiful songs with a lot of repetition. In Apera, the music theater production I composed, based on 10 recorded ape fragments, the Egidius Quartet sings exactly the same fragments, only with one big difference. They sing them really slowly in a very controlled fashion. In conclusion, I think first in evolution of mankind, there was singing. And only after more than 10,000 years, men became able to TEDtalk. When someone is not able to express himself with words, there's always an old remnant, a relic from prehistoric times, somewhere deep in our limbic system. Woo! Ah! As a final example, I present a chimpanzee song with a kind of bluesy melody in the panthood. Enjoy the excellent singing monkeys. Thank you.